let me go into our panelists. And today we have the pleasure of being joined by Johanna Bergan, Executive Director of Youth Move National, Monique Miles, Director of the Opportunity Youth Forum, and the Deputy Director of the Aspen Forum for Community Solutions, and then John Valverde, Chief Executive Officer of YouthBuild USA.
I know that Governor Hutchinson and I are dying to ask you all millions of questions, but we have a group of governors here that we want to have participate as well. And so I'm going to turn it over to Governor Evers from Wisconsin. And thanks for joining us today.
The area that keeps me awake at night more than probably anything else is the issue of juvenile justice reform. Any justice reform is obviously important, but I had the opportunity my first week in office of visiting our juvenile prison, and that's what it is in northern Wisconsin. And it was a controversial piece where for many years the young people there and the adults that ran it were at war with each other. And I came away with lots of ideas, but the most important thing is I came away with these young people, who many of them have done significantly bad things, they're still kids. Mm-hmm. They're still kids. Mm-hmm. And so our state is kind of purging ourselves of this notion and that we need to punish, and moving these young people back into their hometowns and into their neighborhoods, and mm-hmm. getting the mental health treatment that they deserve, getting that second chance that you talked about. And I think that is, even though it's a small end, but it's a very important small end, because retribution has little place in our world. And these young people, especially those that are caught up into our justice system, need a way out, need to make sure that they have the rehabilitation services and the mental health services that they need. And I'm looking forward to having, and so far, having bipartisan support for that effort. So thank you very much.
If I can just add some on-the-ground work. First, thank you very much for your support of YouthBuild in your state. You have a powerful network there that really believes in young people and second chances, and I've had a chance to visit some of the programs, and it's amazing to see what's possible when there's this level of commitment. And in addition to what has already been said, and you know this, I mean, I'm encouraged, but also want to keep an eye on this focus on neuroscience, really recognizing that the young brain is not fully developed until 25. I'll be 50 this year. It's probably not fully developed in me yet either. And really recognizing that they are children. And we've experienced in YouthBuild throughout our network here in this country, about one third of the young people have had criminal justice involvement. So this second chance frame is a powerful frame. I totally agree, trauma-informed care is not enough. Critically important, not enough. We are beginning to do restorative justice initiatives throughout our network, making that part of the culture of YouthBuild. And I want to add the element of love, which isn't often said because it's mushy, and what is love? And while we recognize love is not enough, if a young person feels that someone cares about them, believes in them, the young person starts to trust that person. If the young person trusts that person, they start to share their pain, their trauma, their challenges. If they begin to let those things go, they can actually heal. And if there's a restorative healing frame within the program, that can be accelerated. That really supports the young person's development and transformation. And lastly, I'll say, today in Southern California, we have a resource fair with our Southern Los Angeles Collaborative for the juvenile justice system there. So YouthBuild operates, some of our programs operate within the juvenile justice system, and many of our programs obviously support the reentry of young people returning to their communities, but we're also serving as a diversion program, an alternative to incarceration, and would like to do more of that. We believe that our work and people like us who support young people in this way could be transformative for communities and the systems. Thank you.